This is the video you want to see before you travel to Rhodos in Greece, and watch until the end because I will answer all the most common questions asked online. The most popular question online is what is the weather like in Rhodos? And there is only one good answer for that, and it's good. You are probably coming from UK, where it's raining most of the time, or from Estonia, where it's still winter, or any other place. This is the question you don't have to worry about, because when the season starts in May, the temperatures are all above 20 degrees, and June, July, August, it sometimes goes up to 40 degrees. And to be honest, I have lived here 1.2 years, and I haven't found any accurate weather forecast in here, and all I can rely on is waking up in the morning, go outside and see what the weather is like. During the peak season, the temperatures are around 30 degrees. And sometimes we have also heat waves, like 40 degrees and up. If you come to your vacation in Rhodos, then bring a light jacket, because evenings can be a little bit chilly. The second most popular question is, are there any mosquitoes? Please comment below this video if you know any place where there are no mosquitoes at all. Because yes, in Rhodos there are mosquitoes. They are small, they can't be seen, and they are nasty. They just bite you everywhere and you swell up. So be prepared. And the best way to avoid mosquitoes is not to think about them. Just relax, enjoy your vacation, and the more attention you turn on mosquitoes, then the more mosquitoes will come to you. The third question that is asked a lot is, do you have to exchange money at home or in Rhodos? I will suggest exchanging money at home, because you get better rates, but we have many exchange points all over the town and all over the island. And if you want to cash out some money from ATMs, then try to avoid Euronet ATMs, because then you pay a lot of fees, and try to choose Greece banks like Eurobank, National Bank of Greece and Alpha Bank. Then you get the best rates and you get your money. Can you pay with debit cards and credit cards in here? The answer is yes, but cash is king, and sometimes there are technical issues that you can't pay with card due to internet or something else. So make sure you bring cash also. Now the big question, where are all the sandy beaches? Sandy beaches are mostly located on the east side of the island. And if you're staying in west side, like Iksia ja Lüüsos, Kremasti, or Rhodos town, then you will get pebble beaches, and the first sandy beach is in Faliraki. And also from there on you can find many sandy beaches, like Tsambika Beach, Agati Beach in Lindos, or whatever you like. So if you want sandy beaches, go to the east side and choose your hotel accordingly. Every day someone asks about buses here in Rhodos. So I will try to make it easy. There are two bus stations in Rhodos town. One bus station is departuring buses to the west side, and other bus station is departuring buses to the east side. And bus prices are really good. Basically you can travel 60 kilometers for 6 euros, and buses are really good. They have AC in it and they are modern. Sometimes they get full and you're not picked up if you want to hitchhike from the road and step on the bus from a random bus station. But if you go on the bus from Rhodos city, then you can travel everywhere you want on the island pretty cheap, and there are timetables also. And one thing I want to mention from this year, if you are arriving to Teogaros airport and want to take a bus to the city, then you can't buy a bus ticket from the bus, you have to buy it online. And there is also no ticket stand in airport, so you have to buy it online to get on the bus. One of the most common questions is what are the taxi prices? There are lots of taxi prices, but I try to break it down. If you're coming from airport and want to go to Rhodos city, you have to pay around 30 euros. And if you want to go from airport to Kiotari or Lindos, then the price is between 75 and 85 euros. And if you want to travel from Rhodos town to Prasonisi, then it's around 85 euros one way. There are plenty of taxes waiting in the airport or in Rhodos town, so you will get a taxi. Just to make sure before you sit on a taxi, ask for a price, agree on it, and then travel where you want. They also accept cards and cash. There are many sports fans visiting Rhodos, and of course on your holiday you want to see a nice football match or boxing or something else. So the main question is, where can you find TV to watch live sports from? And I can easily answer that whenever village you are in, you can find a place where they show live sports. And I have seen the most TVs in Faliraki, Rhodos town, and also Pevkos Pevki. So you don't have to worry that you miss any sports event if you're visiting Rhodos on your holiday. Just walk around a few hundred meters and you will find the place. Is Symi island worth visiting? Yes. How do you get there? The easiest option is to buy a ticket online. They are all legit. Or if you want, you can walk around Mandraki port, get a little bit cheaper ticket, but you can see what options you have. There are like five different boats going from Mandraki port to Symi, and the prices are 30 euros up to 50 euros, depending on what you want. Do you want to get there quickly, or you want a slower boat? And if you want to spend a whole day in Symi, then you should try the local transportation. And from Kolona port you can buy a ticket to local ferry and go to Symi, and you can explore Symi island more. Most of the trips from Mandraki port to Symi island usually are about 3 hours, and they also make a swim stop near St. George Bay, which is amazing bay. And everyone should visit Symi island at least once, because it's so beautiful. Is the island of Rhodos a safe place to travel? And the answer to that question is yes, mostly. If 2023 I could leave my car keys in the car and keep all doors unlocked, then from this year, 2024, there are many incidents where some outsiders come and break into rental cars. And this is my advice for you. If you're visiting popular beaches or popular places, please take all your belongings from car with you, so you don't end up coming back to the car and see that your car window is broken and all your stuff is gone. This year I have seen already 3 incidents around Antony Quinn area, Galitea area. So please be safe, take all your things with you, and then you have a worry-free travel to Rhodos. And also, don't get scammed in Old Town. If you walk around Old Town and want to have a beer or a cocktail, then try to avoid Velvet Sports Bar at all cost and some bars next to it, because then you end up paying like 80 euros for a big boot of beer that you didn't order. And also, when you walk around Rhodos town, then you may see some woman trying to give you some bracelets, and then they try to get as much money from you as possible. So just ignore them, walk away, and you will be fine. If you want to watch a video about them, then there are video on my channel. Why hotels ask extra money when you arrive to the hotel? It's because of the hotel tax, which is all over Greece, and it's set by government. So basically what it means is the bigger star hotel you are staying, the more you have to pay. And I will put the prices here. So how can you know how much you have to pay? Is take that number, choose what hotel you have. Is it 4 stars, 5 stars, 3 stars? And depending on the stars, there is a price. And this price is per one person per one day. So if you're coming 5 of you, then you have to multiply it all by 5. And that's what you have to pay per day. And it's paid usually during check-in. So you pay less in 2-star hotel than 5-star hotel. So keep this in mind, so you know what to expect. What are the best places to visit in Rhodos Island? And the answer to that is you should check my YouTube channel, because I have visited most of the places, even twice. And I have been around the island about 12 times or more, I can't even remember. And I have made video about every possible place I have found, so you can find it on my channel. And also I made a short overview about top 31 places to visit in Rhodos. So these are the most popular ones, and you should watch that. Every day I see lots of questions about reviews, about specific hotel or restaurant, and the answer to that is that no one can reply to you exactly, because all the people are different and they give different feedback, and according to their vacation overall, they are maybe giving a not so accurate review. And I have a little story about it. When 5 years ago we came here to our honeymoon with my wife to Rhodos, we stayed in a 3-star hotel, and in the one morning I blew up the water kettle. It was so old, and all the room was white, and the whole hotel lost electricity. But I didn't give a bad review because of that, because our honeymoon went well. Most of the time we spent time outside, enjoyed good food and so on. And the hotel was just for sleeping. So all the reviews are so... no one can really be as same mindset as you are. So keep that in mind. It's... maybe pointless to ask reviews about the hotels, because all the hotels in Rhodos have only one goal: to serve tourists, to give the best experience, and they do the best job they can. So some people are more relaxed about giving reviews, and others are like, maybe I get my money back if I complain a lot. So yeah, it's like you have to choose yourself what is best for you, where you want to go. And it's an impossible answer, basically. These were the most popular asked questions online, and if I did miss something, please comment below this video so I can reply you. And if you found this video useful, please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any other videos about the island. And please like this video, it helps me a lot, and this keeps me going forward making more videos about Rhodos and Greece. So thank you for watching, and see you next time.